Okay, I still haven't decided what I'm doing with the background, but I'm going to go ahead and put in a little of his feathers. I need a little more paint on my palette here. Like I said, these are the same colors that come in the kit. I just put them on a paper plate so they're easier for me to mix. These are high quality acrylic paints. Not quite sure where I'm going on the background yet, but let's go ahead and get his head finished off. Whoops, I stuck my paintbrush in the red paint, which I do not want at the moment. Okay. So, his head here, or this streak on his head, is mostly black, so we're gonna... It's too light. Too wet. Mostly just going to leave it screen, just trying to get the sharp edge here up against the white. And that blue is behind. I'm going to take this part and make it white because I don't think I'm going to put background up that far. So we're just going to continue this right out here. Over this part, let it fade back into black, and then around his eye, I'm going to go back to my little brush. His eye is definitely going to be black, but we're not going to see it if we don't outline it somehow. So I'm going to go ahead. Brush is not included in your kit. It's a very fine, very small, whoops, very easy to drop little brush. And I'm just going to put a little of the black in. You can get pretty good detail on these if you go down to the smaller brushes. But your mind will fill in a lot of the details, so you don't have to get every little thing. Wipe off some of that white paint. There we go. Whoops. So there's eyes standing out a little bit more. As long as I have this little brush, let's go ahead and make a suggestion of the opening in his bill. See, it doesn't have to be real dark. Paint's a little dry. And I always like to put a highlight on the eye. Sometimes I've found that's easier to do at the back end of the brush than the brush itself. Just when you're going small. There we go. I'm not going to worry too much more about that until it dries. Maybe a little more white out here. Go down here and do the same thing with his pin feathers. Like I said, I haven't decided on the background yet. Sorry about that camera movement. They start up in his chest here. So we're just going to keep going back to our white, dragging them out. to make these lines too even, because they kind of just come every which way off of this chest. Brush is getting a little clogged up, so we're adding a little water. And then just go ahead, drop in a few more. They're quite beautiful birds. Okay. So our last little thing for him is to put him on a rock. We're going to go ahead and do the rock part, and then I think we're probably going to call it quits on this video. I'm just making this a little bit lighter so the dark pops a little bit more. And let's go ahead and put him on a rock. Remove the camera again. We'll go down to the big brush. Okay, hopefully I'm not in the way. Okay, big brush again. Still just doing blacks and whites, grays. Getting that light reflecting off this rock in spots. And I want it to be semi-level coming out of the water. So we're just gonna there we go. So now we're standing on a rock. Now we need to decide how much of the background we're going to do. So, maybe I'll put a shot up of them after you get some background on. But there's your basic Heron. Pretty easy to do, pretty quick to do. It took me longer to draw the pattern than it did to paint the bird. And like I said, the pattern will be available for sale on my website, jcneedles.com, and I hope you enjoyed it. I'll give you one more shot with him away. I need to go in for a little bit of a close-up here. You can see I didn't do much to his eye. And there's the Heron. jcneedlespaintedscreenkits.com.